life. Ketchup.
We will ensure justice at every single level.
City leaders promised justice for a heartbroken family after a 9-year-old boy is killed in broad daylight. Loved ones say Devontae Bryant's 10th birthday was a little more than 2 weeks away. Two teenagers were also wounded in that shooting, and NOPD officers believe the suspects got away in this Jeep on your screen. Police say three people dressed in black were inside of this white Jeep Wrangler. The car has black rims, off-road tires, and dark tinted windows. Officers say the license plate was also missing. This morning, Devontae Bryant's family is planning a memorial instead of a birthday celebration, and they want the people responsible for this behind bars. Duke Carter is live in the 7th Ward with more details on this really sad case. Duke.
Good morning, Sheba. Well, yeah, family members of 9-year-old Devontae Bryant are still devastated, can't even process how to lose someone so young to gun violence. And so, as you just mentioned, Sheba, the family, they're seeking justice for their loved ones. So Donald Bryant, which is Devontae's dad, tells us he heard multiple gunshots on Monday evening that unfortunately left his son dead. Police say Devontae was one of three kids who were shot Monday evening. It happened in the 2100 block of Parker Street, that's near North Villery. Now, police chief Sean Ferguson says the three kids were standing outside when people unknown approached them on foot and started shooting at them. Well, of course, the father, Donald Bryant, is hurt by this tragedy. Take a listen.
Killed the child for the life. Catch him.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you.
And you can hear family members as well as Donald Bryant wanting anyone to catch the people responsible for this incident that happened here in the 7th Ward near North Villery and the Parker Streets. And so police say the two other kids involved, a 15 or 16-year-old girl, was shot in the stomach, and a 13-year-old boy was shot in the leg. Those two, they were taken to the hospital, and according to police, they are in a stable condition. Now, right now, there's no word on a possible motive or any reason for this. And again, police are asking anyone with any information about this shooting here in the 7th Ward, please come forward. For now, reporting live, Duke Carter, Eyewitness News.
Duke, thank you. As he mentioned, Police Chief Sean Ferguson is urging anyone with information to come forward. You can send tips anonymously through Crime Stoppers. That's 504-822-1111. In the meantime, while officers investigate the case, neighbors near the scene say they've been pleading with police for a while now because shootings are far too common in the neighborhood.
On for about 2 months now, and had this been happening in the French Quarter or the Marigny, you know, the city would have put the resources in and this stuff would have been shut down a long time ago, but it's just us over here, they don't care.
This is unnecessary, this is unfortunate, and most importantly, this is disheartening for us as a community to accept.
Mayor LaToya Cantrell promises to seek justice at every level for the victims' families. Again, here's a look at the vehicle police are looking for. It's a white Jeep Wrangler with a missing license plate and black rims. And we're going to follow updates from investigators on this case. Look for the latest on our app and here on the Eyewitness News. And Donald Bryant, the father of Devontae Bryant, spoke with us back in February. He opened up about the arrest of another one of his children. His 11-year-old was suspected of being involved in a string of car burglaries.